Hey guys. So today I'm just cruising along on a fire forest road. Not sure what it is. It's probably a fire road. It's very scenic and nice. I really like this road. Has a lot of great qualities. It's pretty mellow, so I pretty much just cruising it, kicking back, sitting most of the time, and just getting to know the bike a little bit more, and just trying to have some fun. It's a beautiful day, 60 degrees, 61 degrees, and there was some fog that rolled off and the sun came out. Really great morning for riding. I got some new gear, which is really nice. I got some new Fox pants, and I spent a little bit more on them, and they're really, really awesome. Really flexible and breathable, and which is totally the opposite of my last pants. My other pants were very cheap and from Amazon. They didn't stretch at all, and very, very hot, and all black. Just very cheap material. So these are sweet. It feels like I'm wearing like some athletic pants, like those warm-up pants, you know, you wear before basketball. Tried to give you guys a view of the lake. It's a nice little lake down there. I've tried to access it before. There is a road that turns off this, but it dead ends. It doesn't look like it goes to it. And I've looked on the maps. There's a road that leads around the other side that looks like it goes to the lake, and maybe you have to hike into it or something, but it's definitely not open for riding a dirt bike or dual sport, and maybe you could get permission to ride out there or something. That'd be really cool to ride out and camp by the lake. I know the Boy Scouts camp out there and fish and stuff, but that'd be a really sweet ride. You could somehow bushwhack a trail down the mountain to it. You know, I could probably go down that road that dead ends and then just, you know, use the hand guards and just whack my way through the bushes on the way down. But it's probably not very legal and probably not very safe. So just cruising today. I really love this bike. I'm gonna give it some time before I do like a full-on review, but I'm pretty sure it's about the best dual sport money can buy, and it's cheaper than some of its competitors. So you're gonna have some downfalls. I've already noticed that it's very difficult to get parts and accessories. There's not a lot of manufacturers making accessories for the Beta, and parts, you're kind of limited to the shopbeta.com website, and it's a really, really bad website. As a designer, I just cringe when I go to it. And not to mention the aesthetic and UX of the site, but basically you'll click on a part and it doesn't always tell you whether it fits your bike or not. There's not a great way to filter the parts specifically to your bike. There is a section that allows you to filter it a little bit, but it doesn't, it's not always clear that it's going to fit your bike in year to year. So it's kind of just a risky thing. You kind of buy it and see if it fits and then return it if it doesn't. So I already noticed that. I tried to replace the throttle body because the previous owner of this bike cracked the throttle body. It looked like the throttle had slid past the handlebar, like maybe half of an inch, and then he dropped the bike at some point and it cracked the throttle body. I'd never seen that happen before. So tried replacing the throttle body, talked to the guy at the shop closest to me, and he ordered it for me. Got next day delivery, which was really awesome. I mean, that's better than Amazon. But turned out to be the wrong throttle body. It didn't work. Didn't have enough clearance. That guy's living his best life, isn't he? truck and the camper and his motorcycle there. Looked like a Yamaha, looked like a WR250, but I didn't slow down enough to see. If he was outside, I would have stopped and talked to him, because I love running into riders out on the trail. It's really fun to get to know people in the sport. But anyway, the throttle body didn't work out, so I returned it. And the guy said he's going to get me a new one that he thinks will fit. For now, I just put some glue on the cracked portion of the throttle body and glued the grip to the throttle body and then just reinstalled it. And it's holding up fine. I don't notice any difference while riding. So for now, it's fine. Quick fix and get it fixed up later. Because I hate to think of that thing cracked in there, and you know, if the crack were to get more severe or spread down the whole body, it could cause problems. So, but that trail to the right there, that road leads down kind of toward the lake, but then it dead ends. And maybe there's a hiking trail there that I didn't notice that goes to the lake. I can ride that, but I didn't notice one last time I scoped it out. I'll have to scope that out again and just see if there's a little trail, because maybe I could ride out to the lake. I don't know if it's kosher or not, but I could try it out. So anyway, I hope you guys are doing well. Think about everyone out there in the world right now, and hope everyone's doing well with their businesses. And if you've been laid off, I'm sorry, because of this whole COVID thing. You know, I've been fortunate in my business, and it's actually been booming since COVID. So I've been really lucky, and I've always worked from home, so it's not a big adjustment. But some people out there are really impacted by this. Feel for you guys. So I hope everything goes back to normal soon and get some normalcy back, and everything opens up and businesses open up and recover, and you know, new businesses spring up, and we just keep living this life. You know, we gotta cherish our lives. And it seems like over a year now, it's our lives have been kind of limited and confined to our home in some aspect, and maybe some of that is good. Gives people a chance to focus on their family life and just hanging out with the family and doing things locally and not traveling and all that sort of thing. But yeah, hope you guys are doing well. What do you guys think? Do you guys ride forest roads like this? Do you just cruise? I like it from time to time. I don't always want to do the difficult stuff, because, you know, the difficult stuff isn't always as fun. It's just cruising and taking in the sights. It's part of the reason I got a dual sport when I first got one, was just sort of that feeling of exploration and seeing the sights. It's like hiking, but so much better, so much faster. And I've always liked hiking and being outdoors, so riding the dual sport is just a natural fit for me. I'm testing out some of the features of the Voyager today. The Voyager, if you don't know, is the Trail Tech Voyager Standard Edition. It's, you can see there on my display screen, it's showing the trail, the road. And it shows the road ahead of me, ahead of the cursor, and the only reason it does that is because I rode this direction already. I'm showing you the way back. So it doesn't show you the roads ahead, and I'm not sure if you can program them or load in the trails and road systems. You probably can, and I'm going to look into that a little bit more. I know one of the next things I can do is get a little micro SD card adapter for, so that I can take the memory card out of the Trail Tech and plug it into my computer, and then I can upload the maps that I've ridden and, you know, track my miles and speed and all that fun stuff. Which, you know, is kind of cool, but for the type of riding I'm doing, I'm not doing like backcountry exploration and long rides, so it's, you know, all these trails and stuff I'm riding are familiar to me for the most part. So it's not super necessary right now, but it's definitely cool to have the Voyager and have the different features. And I mean, it's just nice having all the different things that are already pre-programmed on there. Like even having a temperature gauge is really cool. So anyway, I'll do a full review of this bike at some point once I put more miles, but I hope you guys enjoyed this, and I'll see you next time.